Ange, thanks so much for sitting down with us. It's been a long season, but also it feels like this time has absolutely flown by. How's it been for you?
No, flown by is not how I feel right now. it has been a long season, and but you know, at the same time, like for me anyway, it's been a hugely enjoyable one, a challenging one, and you know, exactly what I expected sort of when I took on the task.
Take us back to the beginning and first joining. What were the kind of expectations that you had?
I think the expectations for me was that it was going to be a challenging year. You know, there was going to be significant change in the way we did things, and whenever that happens, you know, it's going to be really challenging for people. And I do enjoy it. I mean, it's kind of what excites me about sort of starting a new role is that, you know, it's always interesting to see how people react, and people, you know, react differently. And my gut instinct was that, you know, for the most part, I think the players would embrace it. I was really happy with the staff, the coaching staff we'd put together. I was really excited by that. And then from then on, it was just sort of interesting to see where we would take us this year. And from the start of pre-season, you know, we went to Australia. By the end of that trip, I could see that, you know, there was enough there for us to at least start beginning to, you know, become the team we wanted to be.
The new season brings with it an undeniable new era for Tottenham Hotspur. The players, the fans have brought into Ange Postecoglou's philosophy. With Heung-min Son's instatement as the new captain comes a great hope. It's the first at home under the new head coach. Postecoglou is well and truly up and running.
What a way to start.
Another show-stopping performance from Ange Postecoglou's side.
Crowd up, Spurs are up. Kulusevski, he's done it!
It was a special start.
We had a great start, and I think we needed to get off to a great start. If we hadn't got off to a good start in terms of results and performances, I think, you know, it could have been an even more difficult, challenging year than it was. But we had a really healthy squad, you know, we had a strong bench, and that kind of got the momentum that carried us through.
Maddison with Son here. Son again! Porro. What a ball! It's long!
Yes!
Extraordinary!
We just keep going. We have belief that we can get the job done.
Going to the start of the season, 3 Manager of the Month awards. One of the things that I noticed that was really incredible, you always included your coaching staff in everything. It was very much team effort.
Yeah, it's a funny one, the sort of Manager of the Month, because you know that you're just sort of representative of a larger group of people, not just the coaching staff and everyone involved in the football department.
Very key moment in the season was that Chelsea fixture. Can you just talk us through your memories of that evening?
You know, at the time we were flying and we started the game so well. We scored and Sonny was inches offside for getting the second. And then Romero gets sent off, get a penalty against us. Mickey does his hamstring, so you've lost your 2 starting centre-halves. You know, in that moment, my instincts weren't about the game. My instincts were, well, OK, here it is. Here's the first big challenge for us. And through that, all the players were just playing. You know, they just kept playing. Fans just want to see their players giving everything they've got to their football club, you know, irrespective of the outcome. And if you do that, there'll always be an appreciation. There's no doubting that night. The boys emptied the tank. They gave everything. But I walked away going, OK, well, you know, when you lose 3 of a brand new back 4, and I knew for a significant amount of time there were some challenges ahead.
I remember vividly you saying, it's never plain sailing. You never have everyone fully available all the time.
I knew that this would be, from then on, it would be a real kind of interesting insight as to where we're at and kind of, you know, how we react to adversity, extreme adversity. And to be honest, I you know, I was really happy with the way we did that. We still had some tough games and we were still competitive all the way through it. You know, the results were a little bit inconsistent, but every game we were still in it. That gave me also a lot of heart about the spirit within the group. But I also knew that had an end date, because eventually that sort of spirit, you know, it's like fuel, it runs out, you get tired, and I think that caught up with us toward the end of the year. One of the primary reasons I was brought in was to change the football, yeah. And I think most people would agree that that has changed. And I also knew that we'd have, you know, some massive challenges in my first year, and we've had that as well. So I think I've got a really good handle now, having us going through the good times and the adversity of, you know, what it's going to take to get to sort of the next steps.
Can you tell us, give us a little insight, what's to come next season?
I'm pretty confident we'll see our football on a more consistent basis. I'm a lot more confident that the group will be able to sustain our levels of performance. For a lot of our players, this is their first year in the Premier League, or, you know, the first time here at Tottenham. And if that's the baseline where they've played this year, I just think there's real excitement for what they could be in the next couple of years. It has been a challenging year, and kind of it might get skewed a little bit with the way the season's finished, but I think we've had some memorable times, some fantastic games at the stadium, some unbelievable finishes. I think stuff that they'll remember for quite a while, and you know, they were a big part of that, the supporters, you know, the atmosphere they created. It's not coincidence we scored so many late goals and because of the atmosphere they created in the stadium. And I'm really looking forward to again, you know, starting the year in a positive fashion and creating a real sort of unique environment within Tottenham Stadium. And from what I've seen this year, they're going to get some real heroes to follow in the next couple of years. I think that's important for fans. It's not just about the team. They want players who, you know, they want to worship. And I can see quite a few in this group that are going to end up, you know, making a real impact at this football club. And I think the supporters will enjoy watching that happen.